morning, children. Today we are with our new lesson, separation of substances. Here, what is this separation of substances? What substances are present in our surroundings? Means some are in liquid form, some are in solid form, and some are in gaseous form. We know that. Then can we separate all these things? What are the measures we are taking here? What are the substances? According to your textbook, Hemant went to a market and what he purchased? He purchased green chili, tomato, coriander seeds, wheat flour, etc. His mother asked him to go to the market and purchase some sort of grocery and come to home. He purchased all these things and by coming to home, he is running and coming, he just skipped and fall down. All the things from the basket, they came out. So, in hurry, he was tensed and he mixed all the things in the basket. Now, he mixed green chilies, tomatoes, coriander seeds, wheat flour, everything. Okay, how we will make all, mix all the masalas. He mixed these all things and went home. Now, to separate these all things, will we go on with one process or will we go with a different process? To separate all these substances, will we go with the one process or will we go with another process? That only we are talking in this lesson. Okay, in that first let me give one example. First let us talk about the mixture. Okay, so, mixture. What about this mixture? How the substances will be mixed? Here items and here substances. First, suppose I want to prepare a tea. What are the substances required for me to prepare a tea? Here I need milk, sugar, tea powder. Okay? These are the very important. If you want, you can add ilachi, ginger, etc. But tea, if I want to prepare, milk, sugar and tea powder are important. Now, I want to prepare a laddu. Okay, I want to prepare a laddu. For this, what are required? Besan powder. Okay, next I need sugar. Ghee, dry fruits, these are the things needed for me to prepare a laddu. To prepare a laddu, what are the things needed? Besan powder, sugar, ghee, dry fruits, etc. Now, I want to prepare a lemon juice. What are the things necessary to prepare lemon juice? To prepare lemon juice, lemon, water, sugar, if you want you can add a little bit of salt also. These are the things necessary for preparing the lemon juice. Now I want to prepare a mixture of concrete. I want to prepare a mixture of concrete. What are the things required? When we are constructing a building, we will mix the concrete, sand, stones, cement. These are the things necessary for me to prepare the concrete. What are present in the soil? In the soil we can see small pebbles, mud particles, sand particles, some twigs. These are present in the soil. So, you try to observe, I took total 5 items here, tea, laddu, lemon juice, concrete and soil. What are the things required to make sugar tea powder? Laddu, basil powder, sugar, ghee, dry fruit, lemon juice, lemon, water, sugar, salt, concrete, sand, stone, cement, etc. Soil, pebbles, mud, sand, twigs, etc. Means, what is a mixture? The combination of two or more substances is called a mixture. The combination of two or more substances is called as a mixture. Just to tell what is a mixture, I gave you these examples. Did you understand? Now, the combination of two or, this is very important definition. What is a mixture? The combination of two or more substances is called a mixture. The mixture is, we are getting this mixture in two forms. One is natural, the other one is man-made. And man-made. Some are natural substances. Some are man-made substances. Now I will give a few examples. When we are taking here, you can see that the combination of two or more substances is called mixture. Some are natural substances, some are man-made substances. So when I am coming to this natural substances, you can see that in the natural substances, we can take soil. Soil is from the nature itself. We didn't prepare anything. We can see that pebbles will be there, mud will be there, sand particles will be there, twigs will be there, then ants will be there, worms will be there, larva will be there. This all the soil comes under natural. The soil is a natural substance. Natural substance. Okay, again I don't need to give new examples. This four what we are seeing here, tea, laddu, lemon juice, concrete, they come under, what is that, man-made. These come under man-made substances. These come under man-made substances. When you are coming to the soil and what he said, the combination of two or more substances is called mixture. The mixture is in the form of two, some are natural substances and some are man-made substances. Coming to the natural substances, soil, only soil teacher, no, air. Air is a mixture of number of gases are mixed in air. Air is a mixture of number of gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, neon, helium, krypton, etc. These all are mixed in the air. So, air is also a natural resource. Okay. When you are coming to natural substances, you can give soil and air as an example. When you are coming to man-made, tea, laddu, lemon juice, concrete, these all you will give as man-made substances, and natural substances are soil and air. Did you follow? Next one. Here some examples are given in your textbook and he is asking us to find out which one will sink, which one will float, which one will mix in water. So, see here, use of water in separation. How water is useful in separation. So, what are the materials given here is ghee, wax, sand, sugar, salt, turmeric, then dal, next plastic, wood, आयरन ने किया. फ्यू सब्सटेंसेस आर गिवन हियर एंड ही इज आस्किंग दीज पर्टिकुलर सब्सटेंसेस. व्हाट आर दिस? घी, वैक्स, सैंड, शुगर, सॉल्ट, टर्मरिक, दाल, प्लास्टिक, वुड एंड आयरन. These substances will, what will happen if take a bucket full of water and put these substances in that water one by one, not all together, one by one you put it and you try to observe what will happen to these substances in the water. But I am keeping ghee. What will happen in the water? The ghee floats in the water. If I am taking wax, what the wax will do? The wax will float in the water. If I am taking sand, sand sediments, sediment. What is meant by this sedimentation? Sediment means the sand will not dissolve in the water. It will not be soluble in the water. When I stir it in the water, after some time it settles down. Okay. Then sugar is dissolved, means soluble in water. When I am taking salt, salt also will be soluble in water. When I am taking turmeric, turmeric also soluble in water. When I am taking salt, it is insoluble, or this will be sediment. This will be sediment. When we are taking plastic, plastic floats on water. It depends on the weight of the substance. If you are taking light weighted plastic, it will float. If you are taking heavy, it may dip into the water. Wood will float on water. Then when I am taking iron sinks in water. So all the substances what are given here are are they taking all the same category in the water? Means all are having the floating process, or all are having sinking, all are soluble, all are insoluble? No, different substances are having different characteristics in the water. Different substances are having different characteristics in the water. If you take ghee, it floats. Wax, it floats. Why ghee and wax floats in the water? Already I told for you. If the density of the water is more than the substance which you are keeping in the water, what will happen for that one? The substance will float on the water. Means here the ghee and wax are in low density than the water. Because of that, the ghee and wax floats on the water. Sand, it is insoluble, you can tell, or it will sediment, you can tell. Sugar and salt, they are soluble in water. Dal, when we cook also, we can see that it is a solid substance. It will not dissolve in the water. Plastic floats, wood floats, and iron nail sinks. This is an example for what are those for water. In water, what happens to the substances? Next one is the main topic we are coming.
Start.
Our next topic is methods of the very important what we are learning, methods of separation. Methods of separation. In that, first method. What is the first method of separation? Here, you can see that mommy will, what she will do? She will take rice, okay? And she will be ready to clean that rice. Means, what she will do when she is, taking in a plate the rice, and she will remove the stones. Separating, she separates the stones or stone or worms from the rice. Is it correct or not? Now she went to market and she bought different types of vegetables. Now she want to separate the vegetables. Daddy bought different types of fruits. So when you are seeing here, all the fruits are mixed together, all the vegetables are mixed together. When we went to market, we will carry one bag In that only we will keep lettuce finger, in that only potato, in that only tomato, in that only beans, in that only mirchi, everything we will do. Then what is the method we are using to separate the stones and bones from the rice? What we are doing to separate the vegetables and fruits? Now all the dry fruits are mixed together. Dry fruits are mixed together. I want to separate these dry fruits. Separate the dry fruits. So for all these examples, what is the method I am using? The first method of separation is called as the hand picking method. Hand picking method. The first method is hand picking. Is it correct or not? Now our vegetables are there. I am separating tomato or potato, tomato, green chili. Okay. Then here in dry fruits, cashew nuts, kismis, almonds. In fruits, apple, mango, guava, etc. Like this, all are mixed together. I am going to separate these all and arrange in a group. What is the method I am using is called as a hand picking method. My first method is called as a hand picking. Now first I told for you, Hemant has mixed green chilies, tomato, coriander seeds and wheat flour. What is the method he is using? So he is using hand picking method to separate what? The green chili. Easily we can separate this green chili. Okay, next he is separating the tomato. That is also easy for him to separate. Green chili is separate. Now these two are separated by hand picking method. Now what are left over still? Red gram, then coriander seeds, then wheat flour. These are the things left over. By the first method, we can see that by hand picking method, we separated green chili, tomato, then still red gram, coriander, wheat flour are there. How we will separate the remaining methods of separations, tomorrow we will talk. Thank you.